Hold on to the handrail at all times for your own safety. Thank you.
他们冷啊，他们冷。他们冷啊。冷啊。啊，因为不然哪有这样多雾。
anyway, it's already planned. Lunch today provided, Chinese lunch. After the lunch, immediately we. You look at the weather now. It's not very cold, but after 4 o'clock, you will know the wind will come in. So you need a jacket, better prepare to put in the coach. Then after the city tour, then we will put you in the city center, 给你们走走, 因为我们的酒店也是蛮远的, 靠近这边。 So, dinner is time. Little restaurant is around 20-25 minutes only. Okay? Double check your passport, everything with you now. 匆匆忙忙. Now you can see, because now it's autumn, this is autumn leaf. Anyway, let me recommend you our coast captain, Iswan, Mr. Iswan. He will be back with us all the way. Staircase. Actually, earlier when we go out, we can take an escalator all the way up. Because also the escalator spoil, open, we have to take the lift. The guy, certain place they got red, reddish, yellow, very nice. You know, city door, you can see. Around 15, 16. Then after 4, it will drop. Today is Saturday, right? Okay, 我们的车子号码是 700号 700 in front of the coach there is a CTC sign. If you cannot recognize, you just look at our driver, you know already, huh? Only autumn period, I can see it. I think two weeks later, you can see Bo Dao with all the three, and come to New Year. 们吃那个餐厅很靠近他们的棕榈住的地方。
Prime Minister
House， 总理人啊嘛。When you come here, you have to do some changes. Don't use Singapore to compare, especially food wise, this one. Then you must be patient also, when you buy things or what. It's not like Singapore, one sales girl can handle 3-4 person at one time. Here, don't have. Their culture is different, okay?You have to adapt to all this, or 不然的话你就是会生气的哈。
Capital of Germany, 3.5 million inhabitants. By this, it's about 2/3 of Singapore's population. So a little bit smaller than Singapore, but here in Germany, the largest city you will find, there's no larger city than this one. And we will get to the main street of Royal Berlin. As long as we go to the next traffic light, and then we turn left. And then we go all the Linden, and then East Side Gallery, checkpoint Charles de Brandenburg Gate. So we don't have any building for them, a church.In the Roman Catholic phase. Also on the right hand side you will see the Royal Library, which is nowadays also a part of the Left Hand University. So once again, left hand side, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Imperial State Library and Academy of Science in the old days, where Albert Einstein and some of the who pushed Prussia to the Champions League of the European powers in the 18th century. And then on the left hand side, that's the University of Albert Einstein in the old days.And of 28 more Nobel Prize winners. Right hand side, the green cupola building is the Roman Catholic Church. The right hand building on the right hand side is the library. And also the city commander rebuilt from scratch from the damages of the war, was completely gone. Like the palace you see at this huge construction site behind this beautiful bridge. So we rebuilt the palace as museums and libraries. And then look to that bridge. This is called the Palace Bridge. And with scenes from Greek mythology, you see two goddesses, Athena and Nike. Nike, the Greek goddess of victory. Even the times of the emperor could walk from his palace right into that church, into that Berlin cathedral. It also holds the burial place of the royals and the west. But in the old days, this was the very center of Krumpen. East Berlin, the capital of East Germany. We are crossing the second arm of the river, leaving the island where the church and the gates are. Look to the far left hand ground to see a golden dome looking like a font, but being the Jewish synagogue of Berlin. Synagogue of Berlin for the Jewish people. And then, ladies and gentlemen, straight ahead, we see the green top church, that's the second oldest of Berlin. The church is called St. Mary Church, or Church of Our Lady. And the Marienkirche was built up to 1217, so nearly 800 years old, so pretty old church. And this church nowadays is also a Lutheran church, of course, and it was a Roman Catholic church, like all capital of Germany, not only the residence of Prussian kings, but the capital of the North German Union. 2 years later, in 1871, it became the capital of the German Empire. So here sat the Berlin Mayor. This building shows you the self-confidence of the Berliners, the importance of Berlin in the Reich, in the capital, in the German Empire. The mayor is still housed inside this building. Now the Berlin mayor is called Mr. Müller, Jens Müller. And then across the street you see a grey building, and this grey building was the second town hall, which was built 50 years after the first one, when the first one became too small. So that is called the city house. And this darker part in the triangle, that once was the round emblem of East Germany, a hammer and a wheat wreath for the unity of farmers. Just demonstrated it, but you still have this blackish circle in the triangle, showing you that this once was used as a communist government building. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we want to drive just 3 minutes to show you the longest part of the Berlin Wall. Nowadays, ladies and gentlemen, we have to go by intention to see the wall. Without just choosing character is not an abstract political structure. No, it's dividing families, friends, lovers, people from their place of work, people from their place of study. So imagine that once again for Singapore, and suddenly somebody would build a wall right through your street. Maybe you live on one side of the street and your brother and his family lives on the other side with his kids, and every day you could tell your kids, go to your cousins, play with them. Huh? This is not possible anymore. From this day onwards, August 1361, for the next 28 years, you cannot send your kids over the street because they would be shot at. Huh? And you would be shot at if you tried to get over. So this was the horrible situation in Berlin. The Easterners had no freedom, no chance to get to freedom without risking their lives. With paintings related to life under communist regime, or to the opening of the wall, or more general topics like freedom, human rights, and some of the famous pictures, which we are going to see after the next wall, after the next traffic light on the right side. So we just passed this one more traffic light, and then you will see the Berlin Wall, the longest part we still have left. All ready in the coming time, with watchtowers behind, searchlights behind. Dogs running on wires, and they would shoot at you if they would try to stop you at their command. The East German Panzerverband crashing through the wall on the right hand side, test the rest. You see Tellner's funny looking colorful heads on the right. And then further down the road, Gabriel Heinler's men jumping over the double wall. And we are passing an opening of the wall after the next traffic light. So if you look to the right, you will see the river, where you see the men jumping over the double wall, see on the right. But we will see the river, and the river was still communist territory. So as a refugee, you had to swim through the river after miraculously surviving the double wall. So still, if you arrived on the other side, you were safe, finally, in the American sector at that time. But as long as you were swimming, you were still target of the border guards and their boats on the right hand side. So we are on the communist side, and the Americans were on the other side. Maybe he can move it forward. Yeah? This one? Right inside, this is the painting I can recommend you, one of the famous ones. You saw the two men kissing? Looking very strange, doesn't it? So they kiss like lovers on the mouth, and I can tell you they did so because the left hand one is the Russian leader, and in Russia, rock concert, so you can change it from one to the other within just half a day. 17,000 people can watch the games, the concerts, in that Mercedes-Benz Arena. And you see, the painting with the kiss is just across our street. And you walk to the right, and then you enter, you cross the street. Ladies and gentlemen, you are all seasoned travelers, I guess, so wherever we step out, there might... Should you encounter Romanian girls asking you if you speak English, don't give money to them, it's a scam. Ah, they collect money, they pretend to collect money for the deaf and blind, it's not for the deaf and blind. Huh? If you should see Romanian guys playing with three matchbox and you have to find the ball and you see everyone is betting 50 euros winning very easily, be sure everyone who is winning is a member of the gang. When you play, you will lose.
我一定拍了吗？要不我们两个拍一张啊？要你给我拍啊，后面有那个桥的。等一下，等一下。
Germany. To raise the right arm and shout out, you know what I mean. So right inside the long east side gallery, the longest piece still standing of the Berlin Wall. There's no longer than this. And once all this was around West Berlin, you couldn't evade it. And left inside you have the East German cars, these funny looking cars with the round headlights. These cars were produced in the communist times. The car was called Trabant. And because of material shortage, they made the car out of plastic and cardboard. This is not a joke. Plastic and cardboard, like a children's toy. It had a two-cylinder motor, 26 horsepower, so very like rather like a tuk-tuk in Thailand. And waiting time for this car from the moment you ordered it to the day you could drive it, 10 years. Also, this is not a joke. 10 years from the day you ordered it to the day you could drive it. And once again, ladies and gentlemen, you see in the distance the East Berlin Television Tower. You cannot overlook it in Berlin. It's the... Wow! Look to that. Motorbikes over motor... And at home, and if they want the flat rate, they can drink as much as they want. You are getting envious? You shouldn't. You don't have to. This is just a dream of Berlin men like me. No, these are not beer pipes. These are groundwater pipes. Berlin was built on a swamp. Still today, we deal with a high groundwater level. When you have a construction site, after 3.5-4 meters, you encounter groundwater. And if you wouldn't pump it away via these temporary pink pipes or blue pipes, it would be a pool instead of a construction site. So that's the reason for it. That's the German word. F.A. Prost in German, huh? Prost or Prosit. So, ladies and gentlemen, now we are getting back to the oldest part of Berlin. We saw it, the Royal Main Street. I want to show you the church where all the history of Berlin began. Shortly afterwards, we will see a twin tower church with two towers or two spires, which is called Nicholas Church. So this church's foundations are the very core of Berlin, where it was founded. In 1237, we have the first written record of probably Berliners from the 1150s. That is what we call the TV Tower. There's a big square, and there more than 500,000 East Berliners on that day came together to protest against the communist government, to demand reforms, changes. And then the communist government saw this getting out of hand, and they thought maybe they can divert the attention of the people by giving them the freedom to travel. So they would open the borders. Their smart idea was, after a while they would close the border again and all the troublemakers would be shut out. Sounds very smart, isn't it? But proved to be the most stupid plan they ever had, because it was their last plan. As soon as they had opened the wall on November the 9th, they never could close it again. There were always thousands and thousands of people crossing the border that there were not even border checks possible. So and after the wall was gone, the people could vote with their feet under which system they want to live again, and there was not the communist one. So communist East Germany broke down within half a year, and the newly elected last government of East Germany decided with majority of the parliamentarians to join West Germany, and that led to the unification 1 year after the wall fell. There we see the Twin Tower Church, ladies and gentlemen, Nicholas Church. This is the made out of field story, two-storied half-timbered houses, a wooden fence around, which here with golden balconies, the nicest corner of the Berlin, as it was nicknamed, the palace of the master of the mint, a Jewish Berliner called Feitel Eine Ephraim. On the right, the Ephraim Palace.
Turn right and then passing through Jacques.
And they were allowed to build their own church here in Berlin, together with the Berlin Calvinists who built their own church at the other end of the square. Later on, two towers were added in front of the church, churches, and a concert house was added in the center of the square. We are going to see that in about 3 minutes. In front of us, the city palace. So you see, cladded to the old, to the modern building, is the old facade, a copy of the old facade. At Checkpoint Charlie, where we will see a palace. Looking like the old one, or originally like the old one. Good was taken over from the West German version. And then finally, it was about to replace the East German traffic light man by the West German one. And then the East German says, no, enough is enough. Ours is nicer than yours. We don't want yours, we want to keep ours. And they were successful. Now they kept their own traffic light man, while we also have in coexistence the West German one as well here around. So there, for instance, the traffic light, you see the East German one, the West German one, or West Berlin one, was a slim person without a hat. So you in Singapore have nothing to do with that situation here in October 61. You would have died after one of the tanks would have shot the first shot. Fortunately, none of the tanks shot. That's why we are still here. There you will see a photo of a young American soldier. Right behind it is the control house, which is a copy of the real one, which we find nowadays at the Allied Forces Museum in West Berlin. And in front of that control house are fake American soldiers. So these are extras. If you take a picture with them, they will charge you €3. You can do that, they are funny guys. But if you don't want to pay, don't stand next to them. So you have McDonald's, you have Starbucks behind the traffic lights. You have plenty of choice where you can use the restrooms. Be prepared, they will charge you 50 cents.
Wow. 50 cents. Checkpoint.
And here, right inside, you have an excellent opening exhibition with lots of photos, which are interesting. And mind, from here, we will walk down back to the intersection where you find the control house on the way, or the history. And you find there four souvenir shops all around the control house, two on the right, two on the left hand side. So plenty of choice.
Oublie les jours en poste dans ton chemin. Oublie la climat de faim. La climat de sourd. Marco Small, five minutes song. Marco Small in the guitar, he has to get the guitar. Five languages, sorry, he wants to win the CD. What? Which were the five languages? Did you get them? English, Spanish, no, wrong. You got one joker? One more time! Check, 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 you have to drive through. Check, 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 check. Achter die schreien und gully rauf von Barbecue. Auch grillen geht nicht ganz ohne IQ. Mein Reifen wieder platt, bei Scherben in ihm drehen. Doch ohne Glas im Fuß, wär auch mal ganz schön. Von Warschau bis Handy, schön Hauser bis zum Park. Die Massen in der Trinkflaschen stark autark. Wir feiern's auch noch aus, meinem Weib nicht zu sehen. Und jetzt ein kühler Puls, ein Liefer in die Spree. Sack, ist der Berlin Tango. Sehr hab ich sie durch Berlin. Das ist der Berlin-Tango. Ist die Musik der Stadt. Das ist der Berlin-Tango. Mach alles. Das ist der Berlin-Tango. Ist die Musik der Stadt. Das ist der Berlin-Tango. Mach alle anderen sinister.
Alle mal Walzer, Walzer zusammen.
Und wenn die Stadt Regen untergeht.
Is going out, and we are going straight ahead, passing by again a beer bike, or two beer bikes even. The left hand side we have a small bit of the Berlin Wall, I told you, huh? So protected by a fence, a thing you wouldn't do normally in Hitler, the building on the right, very typical architecture of Hitler, followed by the red and goldish Gropius Museum, which was a museum for design and art. Nowadays used for temporary exhibitions. Two statues in front are left as they look like after World War II. Look to the left. Right inside the Berlin Parliament, built as Prussian Parliament within the German Empire, but now the Parliament of the Federal State of Berlin. And Berlin is at the same time also the capital of Germany. The Berlin Wall was on the left-hand side where the buses are parking. So the boardwalk on the left-hand side was American sector. The street we are driving at was Russian sector. And we are turning to the right, ladies and gentlemen, passing by the long stretch of the Berlin Wall, which used to be on the left-hand side. None of the new buildings which you see on the left-hand side was here. There was a vast emptiness here all over the place until the wall fell and then Sony with the glass buildings in front of us, and Mercedes with the red and orange buildings to the left, they built the old and new Potsdamer Platz using the old street outline, putting more focus on our old buildings, on memorial protection. So for us in Berlin, it was quite a new thing to have so much new buildings on one spot. And the Berliners needed a couple of years to come to terms with that, to cope with that modern urban architecture, which certainly is not as high and modern as you have it in Singapore, but well, where they once cut through the city. And then, ladies and gentlemen, the right-hand street called Vossstraße, there Hitler's office used to be. Funny thing today is, the other end, where the other end of the office would have been in the old days, is nowadays a Chinese restaurant called Peking Duck. I really love that, huh? Where Hitler used to reside, a Chinese restaurant. Next street to the right would lead to the secret girlfriend Eva Braun, and where they both killed themselves over occupied Europe out of a racist ideology. Huh? Not very friendly. And then in 1806, the French Emperor Napoleon, he conquered our city and he rode through this gate, making it his Arc de Triomphe. Huh? Arc de Triomphe. And then when he was in the city, he told his officers, well, take the statue down, bring it to Paris. Huh? So he stole the statue for 8 years. It was gone until we conquered Paris and brought it back in a triumphant march. Then the gate became the German Triumph Arch, only to see then finally 1940, behind the white one maybe, only to see then finally. Entering the city limits in the storm of Berlin. Buried on this ground are 2,500 Russian soldiers, and that's just 10% of which the parliamentarians should work for. And this, which was right behind the building, Norman Foster, the British architect, created a new session room inside and a new glass dome on top, which is a beautiful symbol of democracy. We the people, 7 times the office space of the White House, and this is the office where, since 2005, our Chancellor Angela Merkel. And the trees, look to the red colored leaves. These are my favorites here in the autumn time. So these beautiful red colored leaves, they are so nice in autumn. And then in just 1 month, they will be all gone. They will be all at the ground. So right inside, that's the office of the Chancellor, Angela Merkel, who just won her fourth term. She won the last election with a lot of loss, but nevertheless, she is still the most powerful. She has still the most powerful party backing her up. And that's why she will be the next chancellor for the next 4 years. Left inside the Parliament of Germany, the square in front afterwards we'll see, which you saw in the background of the Brandenburg Gate. Right, please.
Okay.
And we are turning to right into that large park, which is called Tiergarten, which once was just a forest outside of Berlin, later on turned into a hunting ground. The rulers of Berlin just put a fence around the park, made the hunting very easier. The animals could not run away too far from the rifles of the hunting party. Only in the 18th century they turned it into a landscape garden, which it is still today, but all the trees were replanted after the war, because after the war the Berliners were cutting all the trees for firewood. Very futuristic building with a ground roof construction, which Hugh Stubbins built, an architect from Chicago. The Berliners get right inside the River Spree, more beautiful red colored trees. Most of them are maple trees, but the German or European version of the maple. And then you see the palace straight on, currently is Mr. Steinmeier, the former Secretary of State. Then the flag will hang or flow on top of the building. When the president would visit Singapore or other foreign countries, then the flag would be gone. So landmark, tricolor. And here we come back to the story between Austria and war against Denmark and the North. First war against Denmark in the north, second war against Austria in the south, in Berlin. And it had students like Albert Speer, the architect of Hitler, and like Werner von Braun, a rocket engineer who first built rockets for Hitler, later on built rockets for the Americans to bring them to the moon. Students of this university in front of us, and then to the right of us. And so we're heading down the Peacock Street, Fasanenstraße in German, which indicates that there was a peacock farm close by, which later on was the core of the Berlin Zoological Garden. We will end our tour next to the landmark of West Berlin, the Emperor William Memorial Church. And this church, ladies and gentlemen, this church was built up to 1895, so the same time like the parliament in the times of the empire, to glorify the church, which then was damaged and nearly in bombing raid in February 1943 by the British. And after the war, they left the ruined standing, the ruined church tower, and built two modern church buildings next to it, which you can take a glimpse in, at least into the modern church. From there, it's a 5-minute stroll alongside shops to the oldest and finest department store of Berlin, full of luxury, LV, Gucci, Longchamps, Hermès, and so on and so on. You find in the ground floor and in the upper floor similar luxury fashion and items. And all this you will see with the red roof, right hand side of the Europe Center, which we will have straight in front of us when we let you out.
And then so you have to grab some food to eat, and you have to walk around. Don't worry about shopping, Don't worry about shopping. Today will be the first day. You still got a lot of things to go,
$5.
$8. Yeah. You can see the church, yeah? In front of police. Oh, in front of police, okay. Okay, here you see a lot of people belonging, important, inside this.
Wow,